Everyone's been telling me about TikTok. Gotta check out TikTok. Why aren't you on TikTok? Let's check it out. I'm just gonna try typing nutrition and see what pops up. Let's just take a look at the first one. How to balance your meal. Protein, carbs, veggies, healthy fats, says there in small print, olive oil and salmon. So high quality fats, high quality carbs, all unprocessed foods. The good thing about having a plate divided in modules like this, it's also easy to swap for personal preference. So somebody prefers to eat a bit lower carb, you swap the potatoes with something else. Somebody prefers lower fat, you just take out the olive oil. So easy to personalize. All right, let's check out another one.
Doesn't it seem so strange that our society eats so much junk food that eating real food is considered dieting?
That's pretty insightful. Yeah, I think in the West, a lot of people have forgotten what real food even looks like. These are nice. These are like 10-second videos, straight to the point. So far, this is pretty solid. Good advice. Everything's reasonable. I heard some scary stuff. People telling me that TikTok is this hellhole of misinformation. You gotta check it out. It's madness. So far, so good. Maybe it's just beginner's luck. All right, let's see one more. 7 things to improve your gut health. From a dietitian, says on top.
If you actually want to improve your gut health and not be tricked by all these people on this app that pretend like they know what they're talking about, here are a bunch of things that are going to help with your gut health. First, you need to get fiber in your diet. That is number one key thing to do.
So the interesting nuance there is sometimes people who have a gut condition already and they're looking for solutions have trouble tolerating certain types of fiber or large amounts of fiber. And sometimes when you have a condition and you just pile on more fiber, they actually feel worse. And paradoxically, there's relief when the fiber, or certain types of fiber at least, are downscaled. Sometimes this leads people to conclude, okay, so it was all a myth. Fiber's bad for me because I actually cut back and I felt better. So there's a really good analogy. If I sprain my ankle and I go for a run, it's not going to feel good. It's going to feel worse. It's going to swell. I'm going to have pain. That doesn't mean that exercise is bad for humans. It means I got to address the underlying condition first, and then I can exercise and reap the benefits of that. It's similar with fiber and gut health. Sometimes there's an underlying condition that needs to be addressed first so that then people can tolerate and benefit from a diverse diet. All right, let's keep going.
Number 2, make sure you're drinking enough water. That helps with the fiber and helps to promote
advice.
Gut health. Number 3, you're going to want to get prebiotics in your diet because this helps to feed your gut bacteria.
Prebiotics is mainly going to be fiber too. There are some other things, resistant starch.
Number 4, you're going to want to get probiotics in your diet, and you can get this through foods as well as supplements.
Fermented foods, yeah, there's a lot of emerging evidence accumulating that it's a good idea to include fermented foods in your diet.
5, you're going to want to manage your stress levels. This is crucial to good gut health.
That's very good, because mood conditions and psychological conditions often co-occur with gastrointestinal conditions. So people who have anxiety and depression, very often they have gastrointestinal conditions as well, and vice versa.
You're going to want to get active, so be more physically active. This helps to improve the motility of your gut. And finally, you're going to want to get quality sleep. These are all things you can do without having to remove a bunch of foods from your diet that you don't actually need to.
This is all excellent. I mean, this is really good stuff. I wonder if because I typed nutrition, I'm getting like higher quality content or registered dietitians that tend to give more qualified information. Let me try to type just diet and see if like crazier stuff comes out. I want to see the crazy. I want the cray cray. Okay. 3 tips to lose belly fat. Let's see what this is all about.
3 tips to help me lose belly fat. This is me for reference. Tip number 1, if you love soda, substitute it for sparkling water. This is the one I use and...
Right off the bat, all these people are really young, really energetic, great energy, great vibe. That's the first impression I get.
Tip number 1, if you love soda, substitute it for sparkling water. This is the...
That's really good. I mean, easy, first kind of low-hanging fruit when you're trying to lose weight is getting rid of sugar-sweetened beverages and soda, because it's a concentrated source of calories. If you can do that, if you can scale down, that's a good start.
Tip number 3, make sure you're walking at least 10,000 steps a day. It's better than running, at least if you're starting. Best way to do cardio, pretty much all three of them.
Yeah, I'd say the best exercise is the one you'll actually do. But it's good. Walking is often better for people who are not used to exercising. It's easier to get started, doesn't tire people as much. Lower risk of injuries as well, especially if people are very overweight. So it's actually a good tip for beginners. Let's check out this one. Best diet of 2023. I think I know what that is.
This diet was voted the best diet of 2023 by the U.S. World and News Report. The diet consists of fruits, vegetables, whole grains, seafood, and chicken. It has been research proven to decrease your risk of diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and increase your lifespan. This diet, of course, is the Mediterranean diet.
Well, he milked it until the end, but yeah, that's about right. It's interesting that none of these videos are revolutionary. It's all stuff that you've heard before, probably, but they're all very popular. Some of these have millions and millions of views. Sometimes people think that to make it on social media, you need to say the opposite of every scientist, and you need to say that everything you've ever heard is wrong. Well, these people are successful, and they're not doing that. They're just, I think it's because they have really good energy. The videos are actionable. They're showing you how they did it. It's inspirational, right? That's my guess anyway as to why they're so popular. So nothing super crazy so far. What if I type cholesterol? That usually when you go into the cholesterol and the heart disease, that's when the hot takes come out. First one is in Polish. Interesting. Okay, second one looks like it's in English. Understanding cholesterol. Let's see.
What are we told when someone has a heart problem? Stop the fats. Why are they told to stop the fats? Because of cholesterol.
Yeah, this is a kind of an old idea that you need to go low fat to lower your cholesterol. It's been known now for many years that it's about the fat quality, not the fat quantity. Some fats actually lower cholesterol, others raise cholesterol. So it's not about how much fat, it's about the type of fats. Then again, this video does look old, so.
HDL is the carrier, and it carries excess cholesterol back to the liver. That's why it's called the good guy. LDL is called the bad guy. But you know, the body doesn't make anything bad.
This is such a basic misconception. I hear this a lot. I think it's because it sounds intuitive, right? Well, my body wouldn't make something that's bad for me. Evolution would have taken care of that. Actually, lots of diseases are caused by overproduction of a metabolite or a molecule. In diabetes, the liver produces too much glucose. That's why you have fasting hyperglycemia. So it happens all the time. Not to mention genetic diseases, scores of them are caused by overproduction of an enzyme or a protein. So this idea that the body wouldn't produce anything that harms me is just a basic misconception. Also, LDL isn't bad. It's having too many of these lipoproteins in circulation that causes problems. It's like every other metabolite. Having too much glucose in the blood is a problem. Doesn't mean that glucose is bad. Having too much sodium is a problem. Doesn't mean that sodium is a bad molecule. So these oversimplifications, we need to be careful with these meme-like statements that just sound like so common sense. Often there's a basic misconception underneath. So yeah, as soon as we type cholesterol and heart disease, all the hot takes come out. It's so predictable. All right, what if we just search weight loss? Foods that help me lose 32 kilos. Did you chop off an arm and a leg?
It's the way that God made me. I'm a devil in a dress on the dance floor, maybe.
Lost a lot of weight.
My mind was running in circles the moment I met you. Don't lie, lie, lie. Cause once you go under, I know you'll be hooked too. I'ma be a new type. From one hit, one look in my body. Boy, I'm changing your life.
Yeah, good foods in general. Foods with a lot of protein, with a lot of fiber, whole foods, unprocessed. So these are foods that are going to help with satiety. So pretty good for weight loss. 6 months of consistency. Consistency is one of my favorite words.
You go to the gym and you work out and you come back and you look in the mirror, you will see nothing. And if you go to the gym the next day and you come back and you look in the mirror, you will see nothing. Going to the gym for 9 hours does not get you into shape. Working out every day for 20 minutes gets you into shape. Not about the events.
This is a really good message because most of us can do intensity. We can have New Year's resolution, go to the gym and kill ourselves for a day or a week. But the consistency, that's what's really hard, is just keep doing it, even lower intensity, but just keep at it day after day for months and years. That's where most of us struggle. And ironically, that's where the results are going to come in the gym and with anything in life. So in general, my first impression of TikTok is very positive. Most messages are reasonable. They're healthy messages, both physically and in terms of mindsets. Maybe I just got lucky and didn't tap into all the creative content that people have been warning me about. Should I start making content on TikTok or should I stick with YouTube? What do you guys think? Let me know below. Here's a video about cholesterol and heart disease, and here's one about weight loss and calories and different diets. Check those out. I'll see you over there. Bye.